You've probably tried everything. Counting calories, cutting carbs, running endless miles. Yet that stubborn belly fat seems to defy all logic. But here's the shocking truth. Your body isn't broken. In fact, it's doing exactly what it was designed to do. Survive. From an evolutionary standpoint, belly fat, especially visceral fat, was a critical energy reserve that kept humans alive during times of famine. The body evolved to hold on to it as a form of protection, not punishment. When you diet aggressively or push yourself too hard, your brain reads those actions as signs of danger, triggering a biological defense mechanism. That's when everything slows down. Your metabolism drops. Hunger hormones like ghrelin surge, and fat-burning hormones like leptin fall. Your body begins to fight back, trying to save every ounce of energy it can. That's why you might notice your arms, legs, or even your face getting slimmer while your belly refuses to budge. It's not about willpower or discipline. It's about deep, ancient survival programming. And unless you understand the science behind it, you'll keep repeating the same frustrating cycle. So the real question isn't how to lose belly fat. It's why your body refuses to let it go. Because once you uncover that secret, everything about fat loss changes. Stay with me. I'll reveal what's really locking that fat in place in just a few minutes. If you've been told that doing crunches will melt away belly fat, you've been sold one of the biggest fitness myths ever created. The idea of spot reduction, losing fat from a specific area by exercising it, sounds logical, but biology doesn't work that way. When you work out, your body decides where to burn fat, and it never listens to your wishes. You might feel your abs burning, but that's muscle activation, not fat loss. In a 2011 study published in the Journal of Strength and Conditioning Research, scientists tested this very theory. Participants did weeks of abdominal exercises, expecting to shrink their waistlines. The result? They gained stronger abs, but their belly fat didn't change. Fat loss happens systematically, driven by overall energy balance and hormones, not by isolated movement. This means those long ab sessions, those gadgets promising six-pack miracles, and even those viral belly fat burner routines, they're all missing the point. The key isn't to attack your belly, it's to train your entire metabolism. Once you understand that, every effort you make finally starts to count. Imagine your belly fat as your body's secret emergency fund, stored close to your vital organs, easy to access when energy runs low. From an evolutionary standpoint, this was brilliant design. When food was scarce, that centralized energy source could keep you alive for days. But in modern life, where food is abundant and stress is constant, this system backfires. Your body can't tell the difference between a famine and your stressful job, your lack of sleep, or that cup of coffee you skipped breakfast for. To your brain, all of these feel like threats, so it holds on to belly fat just in case. The more stress signals your body receives, whether physical or emotional, the more it reinforces the message, "Don't let go of that energy. We might need it." This is why even people who eat relatively well and exercise regularly can still struggle with a soft midsection. The problem isn't laziness or bad genetics. It's that your body doesn't feel safe enough to release that stored energy. The secret isn't to fight your body, but to calm it. Only when your system feels safe, nourished, and balanced does it finally let go of its treasure. Cortisol is one of the body's most misunderstood hormones. It's not evil. In fact, it's essential for energy and alertness. But when cortisol levels stay elevated for too long, something dangerous happens. Your body starts storing fat, especially around the abdomen. Why there? Because belly fat cells have more cortisol receptors, meaning they respond more quickly to stress hormones than fat in other areas. When you're constantly under pressure, mentally, emotionally, or even from sleep deprivation, cortisol never gets the signal to shut off. That keeps your blood sugar high, your appetite uncontrollable, and your fat cells in storage mode. A 2014 study from Yale University found that people with chronic stress had significantly more visceral fat, even if their total body weight was normal. The culprit wasn't overeating. It was the body's hormonal response to stress.
This means that your belly might not be growing because of what you eat, but because of how you feel. Learning to manage stress through sleep, mindfulness, or breathing techniques can lower cortisol and unlock fat loss far more effectively than another crash diet ever could. We all know someone who says, "I just have a slow metabolism." But here's the truth. The difference in metabolic rate between people of similar body size is surprisingly small. What really changes is how efficiently the body uses energy. When you eat too little for too long, your metabolism doesn't stop, it adapts. It becomes smarter, more efficient, burning fewer calories to keep you alive. That's why extremely restrictive diets often backfire. When your body senses a shortage of food, it lowers your thyroid hormones, slows your calorie burn, and starts breaking down muscle tissue, the very thing that keeps your metabolism active. Muscles are your internal engines. Lose them, and your metabolic power plummets. So the secret isn't starving your body. It's fueling it strategically. Eating enough protein, sleeping deeply, and training with resistance all send your body a clear message. We're not in danger. You can burn energy freely. And once your body believes that, fat loss stops feeling like a war and starts feeling like alignment. You might think of sleep as downtime, but for your metabolism, it's prime time. While you sleep, your body recalibrates its hormones. Insulin sensitivity improves, hunger hormones balance out, and growth hormone spikes, helping your body repair and burn fat. But when you don't get enough rest, everything flips. Cortisol rises, ghrelin, the hunger hormone, goes up, and leptin, the satiety hormone, crashes. This hormonal chaos tricks your brain into craving quick energy the next day. Sugar, carbs, caffeine, anything that feels comforting and fast. Studies from the University of Chicago have shown that sleeping less than 6 hours per night can increase fat storage by over 30%, even with the same calorie intake. Sleep deprivation doesn't just make you tired. It rewires your metabolism to save fat instead of burning it. So if you're trying to lose belly fat, sleeping isn't being lazy, it's being strategic. It's the quietest, most natural form of metabolic optimization your body has. One night of quality rest can do more for your fat loss than a week of desperate dieting. Here's a hard truth. Sugar hides in plain sight. You might think you've cut it out, but it lurks everywhere. In yogurt, sauces, protein bars, and healthy drinks. Every time you consume these hidden sugars, your blood glucose spikes, insulin floods your bloodstream, and your body gets a clear message: store fat, not burn it. Insulin's job is to move glucose into your cells for energy, but when it's constantly elevated, your body loses sensitivity to it, a condition known as insulin resistance. And guess where the excess glucose ends up? Around your waist. The liver converts it to triglycerides, which then accumulate as visceral fat. It's a slow, silent process that happens long before weight gain becomes visible. That's why people often say, "I don't eat much, but I still gain belly fat." The problem isn't calories, it's insulin mismanagement. Reducing sugar isn't just about willpower. It's about reprogramming your hormonal rhythm. Once you lower insulin levels, your body finally gets permission to tap into its fat stores again. Have you ever lost weight fast, only to gain it back even faster? That's not failure, that's biology. When you restrict food too severely, your body thinks you're in danger. In response, it lowers your metabolism, increases hunger hormones, and stores fat more efficiently. Once you start eating normally again, the body, still in survival mode, clings to every calorie. That's the rebound effect. Research from the National Institutes of Health found that after extreme dieting, people's metabolic rates can drop by up to 15% and sometimes stay that way for years. The result? You eat like before, but gain weight more easily. It's a cruel biological safety net meant to keep you alive, not lean. The smarter way isn't to starve your body, it's to rebuild trust with it. Gradual, sustainable calorie reduction combined with resistance training and adequate protein tells your body it's safe. And when your body feels safe, it lets go of what it was once trying to save. Insulin resistance is often the invisible wall between you and fat loss. When your cells stop responding to insulin properly, your body pumps out even more of it to compensate. High insulin levels block fat burning, literally turning off your body's ability to access stored energy. Instead, the body keeps shuttling glucose into fat cells, particularly around the abdomen. This is why some people can exercise daily and eat well, yet still gain belly fat. The problem isn't fewer carbs, it's restoring insulin sensitivity. That means eating whole, unprocessed foods, spacing your meals to allow insulin levels to drop, and improving muscle mass through strength training. Every rep, every night of good sleep, every nutrient-dense meal slowly retrains your body to listen to insulin again. Once that happens, your metabolism wakes up. Fat burning becomes natural, steady, and effortless, not forced or temporary.
You've probably seen it. Someone running for hours, sweating buckets, yet their belly barely changes. That's not because cardio doesn't work, it's because your body prioritizes energy use differently. During long, steady workouts, your body burns a mix of fat and carbohydrates, but it also adapts quickly, becoming too efficient. That means fewer calories burned over time. High-intensity interval training, or HIIT, on the other hand, creates something called EPOC, excess post-exercise oxygen consumption. It's a fancy term for what happens when your metabolism keeps burning calories for hours after you finish your workout. Strength training has a similar effect by increasing muscle mass, and as you now know, muscles are metabolic gold. So while endless cardio sessions might feel productive, they're not necessarily targeted. The real belly fat burners are workouts that build muscle, stress the body in short bursts, and trigger hormonal responses that last. It's not about doing more, it's about doing what works smarter. Before we wrap up, tell me in the comments which part surprised you the most so far. The role of stress, sleep, or sugar. I want to know what hit home for you. It might sound strange, but your emotional state has a direct line to your waistline. When you experience chronic stress, anger, anxiety, or sadness, your brain releases cortisol and adrenaline, the same survival hormones that once helped humans run from danger. But in today's world, those dangers are emotional, not physical. They linger, day after day, keeping your body in a low-grade fight-or-flight mode. This hormonal cocktail tells your body to store energy. And where does it store it first? Around the organs. Belly fat becomes your body's emotional armor, a literal buffer between you and the world. In neuroscience, this connection is called the gut-brain axis, and it's no metaphor. Your intestines are lined with over 100 million neurons, constantly communicating with your brain through the vagus nerve. When you're tense or emotionally overloaded, digestion slows, inflammation rises, and your metabolism suffers. Healing your body starts with healing your emotions. Meditation, journaling, therapy, or even deep breathing are not soft habits. They're biological tools for fat regulation, because a calm mind tells your body one powerful message: you're safe now. You can let go. Most people don't realize that the way they breathe shapes their metabolism. Fast, shallow breathing keeps your nervous system in a constant state of alertness, spiking cortisol and blood sugar. Slow, deep breathing does the opposite. It activates your parasympathetic system, lowering stress hormones and improving oxygen delivery to tissues. A study from Harvard Medical School found that practicing slow diaphragmatic breathing for just 10 minutes a day can significantly reduce cortisol levels and improve insulin sensitivity. That's right. Something as simple as breathing correctly can literally change how your body processes fat.
When you combine deep breathing with mindful awareness, slowing your heart rate, focusing your attention, your body starts to reprogram its stress response. Over time, that means fewer fat storage signals and more fat burning opportunities. Breathing isn't just about air. It's about control, balance, and teaching your body to stop living in survival mode.
It's not the big things, the skipped workouts or the cheat meals, that usually sabotage progress. It's the small, repetitive habits that fly under the radar. The late-night scrolling, the stress snacking, the endless sitting. Every small decision compounds. Each moment your posture collapses, each sugary sip you take just this once, adds up to hormonal signals that tell your body to hold on to fat. Research shows that sitting for more than 8 hours a day reduces the activity of the enzymes responsible for breaking down fat in the bloodstream. Pair that with constant exposure to artificial light and blue screens that disrupt your circadian rhythm, and your metabolism gets trapped in a low-energy loop. But the fix isn't about perfection. It's about awareness. Stand up every hour. Get morning sunlight. Take walks after meals. Hydrate deeply. And create boundaries with your devices. These small adjustments may not feel dramatic, but together they whisper to your body, "We're thriving, not surviving." Here's the paradox. The more you restrict, the more your body resists. Real fat loss doesn't come from punishment. It comes from balance. When you eat nourishing foods, move your body joyfully, and rest properly, your metabolism aligns naturally. Your hormones stabilize, cravings diminish, and your body finally begins to trust you again. Science calls this homeostasis, the state of internal balance your body constantly strives for. But emotional balance matters too. The guilt and anxiety attached to dieting often do more harm than an occasional indulgence. Studies show that people who enjoy their meals without shame digest food better and maintain lower cortisol levels. The secret isn't eating less. It's living more fully. The human body doesn't respond to deprivation. It responds to safety, consistency, and nourishment. When you find that sweet balance, the results last, not for weeks, but for life. If you've ever wondered whether fasting could finally unlock that stubborn belly fat, don't stop here. In the next video, I'll show you exactly what happens inside your body when you do intermittent fasting for 30 days, and why it might be the missing key your metabolism has been waiting for. Tap right here to watch What Happens If You Do Intermittent Fasting for 30 Days, Science Explained, and see how your body transforms when you stop feeding it and start trusting it. There's a moment, often subtle, sometimes emotional, when everything starts to click. Your sleep improves, your hunger normalizes, and the belly that once felt stuck begins to soften. This isn't magic. It's physiology aligning with peace. When your body feels safe, when your hormones are balanced, when your habits are steady, fat loss becomes effortless. That's the real secret science never hid, but we rarely listen to. Your body is not your enemy. It's been protecting you all along. The goal isn't to fight it. It's to understand it. Once you work with your biology instead of against it, the results follow naturally. So, if you've been chasing diets, burning out in workouts, or blaming yourself for stubborn belly fat, stop. The answer isn't out there. It's inside you. Reconnect with your body, calm your mind, nourish your system, and your body will do the rest. If this opened your eyes, hit that like button, subscribe for more science-based wellness content, and share this video with someone who's struggling, because they deserve to know the truth too.